Welcome to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield, and tonight we have an unbelievable amount of new videos for you from the likes of Placebo, The Odds, Eels, James, The Chrome Cranks, Moby, Beck, and many, many more, including a sneak preview of the latest from The Offspring. And if that wasn't enough, Jimmy Pop Ali of the Bloodhound Gang is going to stop by and hang out with us for a while as well. First up, though, a new video from the Bostonian ska band, the Mighty Mighty Bostones, with their fifth full-length record, Let's Face It. Remember that old 999 song? But I don't know if that's on the record or not. Just know it's the same title. Lead singer Dickie, who's a great frontman, says he's finally got to show a little bit of his melodic side. Here's Mighty Mighty Bostones with The Impression That I Get, new on 120 Minutes. Thanks for parodying me in the video. I enjoyed it immensely.
You're the only VJ that deserves that.
Well,
you know,
thank you.
You're the one that knows it all, you know, and we can get into that later, talk about the video and all that good stuff, but...
Let's talk a bit about, actually, where you guys are from. You're from Pennsylvania, that area, like King of Prussia and that area.
From the burbs, as we call it.
Is that where you...
Welcome back to YoMTV Raps.
Now, where did you meet the rest of the guys in the band?
Some at school. I was working at the King of Prussia Mall as a janitor, and I was also a vacuum cleaner specialist, and just around, just... Five losers.
Now, did you start out as a cover band originally, doing Depeche Mode songs? I had read that.
Stop this interview. Yeah, we did. We were doing Depeche Mode covers, and I was wearing a Hawaiian shirt, and every week you'd have to get a new gay singer to get up there, and strange love.
So were you actually trying to look like different members of the band at that time?
Or? No. To do that, I'd have to shave all my body hair. You know, and I have too much of that, so we never tried to go for the Depeche Mode look.
I see.
You know, because it's always very...
But you're a huge fan of this. You're actually going to be on a covers album.
Yeah. Some of our friends, God Lives Underwater, are putting out a covers record, so we're trying to get a couple people together to do a cover of Photographic, I Take Pictures.
From Speak and Spell, right? And actually, Failure's going to be on there doing Enjoy the Silence, right? And
yeah.
Let's talk a bit about God Lives Underwater. You're actually... You're good friends with one of the guys in the band. He grew up with you?
We grew up in the boondocks together, and they kind of taught me how to use my samplers. I taught them to light their own farts. It's kind of a fair trade as far as I was concerned.
It's kind of Zorches or whatever.
I just feel like making out with you, Matt. Just a kiss. I come in for a kiss. You're just like gleaming in my eyes, and I'm in the presence of
God. It's actually
the
shine of my head.
Because honestly, before we go to a video here, let me just say that this man, he knows everything about anything you could possibly know about music. And that's why you're perfect for this show.
Well, thanks.
You know, and later let's talk about some of the people that have come on the show in the past that you haven't liked. And if you don't want to, I will. Because I have a real problem with James... And Darcy.
Oh, I love them, actually.
Oh, my. I just wanted to bash their pumpkin heads together when they were wrong.
See,
they're like,
them.
Matt.
Nah, you know, it's just their manner, actually. I liked them, though. Jimmy will be back to talk with us some more. But in the meantime, here's Whitetown, which was only the fourth record to go to number one in England and debut there.
I'm Darcy.
From his new CD, Animal Rights, that was Moby's cover of Mission to Burma. That's When I Reached for My Revolver, which was a big indie hit in the early 80s from their Signals, Calls, and Marches EP on the Ace of Hearts label out of the Boston area. Jimmy Pop Ali from the Bloodhound Gang is here hanging out licking my neck. Jimmy, tell me a bit about your first record, Use Your Fingers. Was actually quite a bit different than this record.
Yeah.
And you did Mama Say, which had that thing that most people think it's from Michael Jackson, want to be starting something. But
that's where I thought it was from when I did it.
It was Mano Dubingo or Dubango or, and Soma Cosa. And you, I heard he sued you guys?
That's right. He's from France, and I guess, the Frogs were playing it over there, and they heard it, and he heard it on the radio, and they pulled it from the shelf, so he couldn't sue him.
Yeah, now, the lineup of the band changed. Was there a reason for that besides?
Yeah, some of them don't like me. Some of them went back to work, and, with our last record, much like this one, probably, we're not going anywhere. So, it's just kind of like my pet project that I do, and, Lupus was on the last record. That's our guitar, Snape. His name's Lupus. Hey, okay, though.
Yeah, now, One Fierce Beer Coaster, actually. The style of music, I mean, there's certain things that are similar to the first record, but there are a lot that are different. And in the song, Fire, Water, Burn, it's almost like a deconstruction of what you were doing before. It was cool. You're kind of like making...
The best definition of postmodern, really. Because what you're doing is you're taking something from the past, you're mangling it, and you're giving the people something to do. Because with my new record, I want people to know what it's actually like to kill a puppy with the bare hands, right?
And with that, we'll be back with Jimmy and the Bloodhound Gang video, Fire, Water, Burn, in just a minute. In the meantime, here are the top 10 singles on alternative music. Check it out. Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield, here with my special guest, Jimmy Pop Ali from the Bloodhound Gang.
Nina Blackwood's back here. Wow. All right. Hey, we're back.
She was in that movie Vice Squad. Do you remember that?
No.
B-movie that was on cable a lot when we were kids.
Yeah, I always wonder what happened to the VJs that have come and gone. Yeah, I see Kevin Seal on the street selling pencils, and I see Martha Quinn doing those skin ads.
Right.
Yeah.
Not skin, nude skin, but skin.
No.
Pimple ads. Oh, you saw some other stuff?
Yes. No, but, yeah. So.
Let's talk a bit about how you came with Firewater Burn, how you came to actually do the imitation of myself, and we met at Two Boots Pizza downtown here one day.
That's right. We go way back. We
it was about 7 months or so.
Yeah, you were sitting there having pizza, and I said, "Hey, Matt Pinfield." And you're like, "What?" "I do an imitation of you." And you're like, "Leave me alone. I'm trying to eat my pizza."
I did not say that, though.
Well, no.
I was very nice.
I should mention to the audience members, there were 10 pizzas there in front of him that he was trying to go through.
I was trying every variety.
Every variety.
Louis Largent was helping me, remember?
Yep, Lou was there. And, yeah, bro, Lou was there. What am I, Mr. Industry? Yeah, bro, Lou was there. It was really great. We were all just hanging out. And jet out to the coast, and we'll do some lunch, bro. You, me, Lou, and we'll get we'll get Mick and Keith in on the deal.
That's right. Well, we invited them, but they weren't for the Two Boots.
Right, no. Right. I don't think they can walk. They're how old are those guys? Rolling Stones.
Hard to say, actually.
Yeah, they're grandparents. I know that. But yeah, so we met down at the Two Boots. We were hanging out, and I came up, and I must have done something like
you did the Pixies Family Tree, which I really enjoyed.
Well,
we were laughing really hard.
Yeah, no, the one that I enjoy when people say, "Hey, how do you do that Matt Pinfield imitation?" And it's a good one to start with is Dave Grohl, because you can leave. Plus, with Mike Watt, you have a whole realm you could go into there.
Yeah.
But just being like, "Hey, that was a video by the Foo Fighters. Of course, that contains Dave Grohl, who used to be in Nirvana, which of course everybody knows. Kurt Cobain was in Nirvana, which of course married the Courtney Love of Hole, and she did that song on that Germs compilation, I think it was, with Pat Smear, who happens to be in the Foo Fighters. So here's a video by Lisa and Nicole Jam."
There you go.
No. And that always really amazed me how you did that.
No, it's fun though. I mean, we enjoyed that. And the video itself with you. How did you get all those old folks together to do that at Home for the Deaf?
Yeah, no, they are, a lot of them were just actresses and actors from the past. The lady that lifts up her skirt in the video, who happens to be the one I scored with.
Yeah, you rocked in a big way there.
That's right. I still have cobwebs in a jar to show that I hooked up with her.
You're going to have to show this to me later. Well, here they are from One First Beer Coaster. Here's the Bloodhound Gang at Firewater Burn.
Pat Minfield here. Welcome back to the shorter half of 120 Midgets. We're going to be showing you a clip by the Bloodhound Gang. The song's called Firewater Burn. In this song, they make a reference to Emmanuel Lewis. Now, you might remember him from back in the Webster days on TV. His dad was played by Alex Karras, who, of course, was formerly with the Detroit Lions. He also played Mongo in Blazing Saddles. Now, that was directed by, I think it was Mel Brooks, who happened to be married to Anne Bancroft. You might remember her as Mrs. Robinson in The Graduate. Of course, on that soundtrack was the song Sounds of Silence, big hit for the folk duo Simon and Garfunkel. If you remember, they did like a reunion show at, I think it was Central Park. Also, Diana Ross tried to do one of those, failed miserably, right down the drain. Now, she was in the Supremes, but she was also in that movie The Wiz with Michael Jackson. And if you remember, Michael Jackson was playmates with Emmanuel Lewis. So let's check out that video and keep an eye out for that reference, because you know he was our featured midget.
My name is is Jimmy Pop and I'm a dumb white guy. I'm not old or new, but middle school, fifth grade, like junior high. I don't know, mofo, if y'all peeps be bugging, giving props to my cushy fly, but I can take the heat, cause I'm the other white meat known as Kid Funky Fry. Yeah, I'm hung like planet Pluto, hard to see with a naked eye, but if I crashed into Uranus, I would stick it where the sun don't shine, cause I'm kind of like Han Solo, always stroking my own Wookiee. I'm the root of all that's evil, yeah, but you can call me Cookie. The roof, the roof, the roof is on fire. The roof, the roof, the roof is on fire. The roof, the roof, the roof is on fire. We don't need no water, let the mother burn, burn, mother. Yo, yo. This hardcore ghetto gangster image takes a lot of practice. I'm not black like Barry White. No, I am white like Frank Black is. So if man is five and the devil is six, then that must make me seven. This hockey's gone to heaven. But if I go to hell, well then I hope I burn well. I'll spend my days with JFK, Marvin Gaye, Martha Ray, and Lawrence Welk, and Kurt Cobain, Kojak, Mark Twain, and Jimi Hendrix, Poltergeist, and Webster, yeah, Emmanuel Lewis, cause he's the Antichrist. The roof, the roof, the roof is on fire. The roof, the roof, the roof is on fire. The roof, the roof, the roof is on fire. We don't need no water, let the mother burn, burn, mother.
I'm Matt Pinfield, not Pat Minfield, but I'm here with Jimmy Pop Ali from the Bloodhound Gang. I do enjoy that, though. The ball cap and all that stuff. How long did it take you to get the imitation down? I gotta know.
Got a lot of free times, so I had a way masturbating and Matt Pinfield imitations. And that's what I filled up my time with. And it actually took me about 4 or 5 hours to get in that outfit. And we were doing all kinds of, just outtakes.
I hear some really rude outtakes.
Yeah, some rude outtakes about Kennedy and things like that. And,
I'm sure she'd like to see him too. She'd enjoy checking
him out. Yeah, well, next time I'm over at her house because I have to go pick up my jacket, I'll show him to her.
Vanilla Ice, you actually, Rob Van Winkle, he's on the album.
Yeah.
You're like dueling.
Yeah,
raps.
We're dueling.
Talk to me about that. How did that come about?
Well, as you might know, Rob Van Winkle is one of my peeps. And so we took our Mad Flava skills and we mixed them together and we came up with this rudimental jammy jam. That's it's Boom is the name of the song.
Yeah, right. And there's that whole thing about you get some good digs in there. It's fun.
That was one. It's kind of funny because he's much more street than I am, and I just sound like I'm trying to sound tough, but I definitely come off as being the biggest wimp, you know, and you can tell that I've had my head bash against a thousand lockers when you listen to that song. Some people say I sound like Shaggy. Like that kind of voice.
Are you a Shaggy fan?
No, not that.
Oh, I mean,
I meant
Casey Kasem Shaggy.
Scooby-Doo, give me another Scooby snack. They don't know what that's all about.
Yeah,
that's
right. Scoop. Yeah.
That's Shaggy.
Yeah, that is.
That's Scooby, that's Shaggy.
That was Casey Kasem doing his voice, too. Isn't that funny?
I just don't know how they sat in those van with those two hot chicks.
All that time of no love?
That no love. That's right.
I'm not sure.
You gotta, it's like, I don't know. I'm surprised Edith never, you know.
Yeah.
No, I don't want to go into the Archie bunker.
Now, Nerf Herder you're going to be touring with, right?
That's right.
So people can
probably one of the best bands of the year, in my opinion.
You're a big fan of theirs?
Big fan of Nerf Herder.
Yeah, so it's cool. That'll be good. But I appreciate you coming by, Jimmy.
Hey, thanks for having us.
It was fun. It was a good time.
Good time. And, you know, now we're going to go pick up some chicks.
And have some fun. So
that's
anyway,
right.
120 minutes will turn in just a bit with a new video from the Squirrel Nut Zippers.
So don't go away, man.
That's right.
So get out your lead pipe dreams. Get out your 10-foot flags. The insects are huge and the poison's all been used. And someone kissed their own ass by mistake. That's why. Pay no mind.